Welcome back to Pre-Algebra, Chapter 6, Section 1 in this book. And today we're going to learn about ratios and rates. So a ratio is how you compare two different numbers to each other, sort of by dividing. It makes more sense once you see an example. They're read and written like this. So this, you read it A to B, A to B, A to B. Now, these are going to be fractions that we reduce. That probably didn't make any sense. Don't worry, it will in a minute. All right, for example, we are doing archery, and we want to compare the number of hits to the number of misses, okay? So we got 44 hits and 16 misses. So we can say it's 44 to 16. That's absolutely correct. But remember I said they want us to reduce it. So we can say, we can actually get our calculator to reduce it for us. So what you do is you turn on your calculator and you put in 44 divided by 16. Remember that's the fraction bar that means divide. And you get a decimal point, 2.75. And then if we want to turn it into a fraction, we say math. And which is kind of funny. That's, I always say it's the ironic button, because aren't they all math? And then the first choice is one, arrow frac, it means turn it into a fraction. And so you hit enter and it tells you 11 over 4. Now if you don't have the TI-84, you need to get one next year for Algebra 1, but even the TI-30s do it now. What they do is they have a button that says something like N over D, numerator over denominator. You're going to just have to look and play around with whatever calculator you have. But calculators will now reduce fractions for you. So you do the numerator divided by the denominator, enter, so that it's a decimal, then say math, enter, if it's the TI-84. And it reduced it for us, 11 fourths. You can also write it this way, 11 to 4, 11 to 4. Those are all correct. Okay? So then they said, well, what about if it's the number of hits to the number of shots? Well, the hits plus the misses is the number of shots, so that's 60. And so it's 44 over 60, then do 44 divided by 60, math, enter, and you get that it's 11 fifteenths. Now, the old way to do this before the calculator, how you reduce a fraction is you say, what number goes into both 44 and 16? 4 does. 4 goes into 44 11 times, 4 goes into 16 4 times. So that's the old 80s way I learned it. But now we have these calculators and I want you to get good at them and know everything that they can do. Okay, so here's another one. So ratios we talked about. Rates is where you have dividing with two different units. We're most familiar with the speed limit. Every now and then you get caught having too high of a rate. And the police don't like that. One time I was zipping along, didn't realize I'd gotten a little fast, and a police officer who looked 18, I mean, he looked really young. I'm sure he wasn't, but he looked 18, pulled me over, and I thought, what'd he pull me over for? I didn't even realize I was speeding. He said, ma'am, do you realize you were going 3 miles per hour over the speed limit? I almost laughed, because I thought, you know, it just said 3 didn't seem like that big of a deal. But anyway, he let me off with a warning. So if you're out there, policeman, thank you. I've never had a speeding ticket, ever, or any ticket. I'm a very law-abiding math teacher. All right, so miles per hour you're used to. You read the divided where it's the units per. And it's okay if it's units to do the divided sign as a slash. But if it is numbers and it's a fraction, I want flat fraction bars. I'll show you why. See this 11 divided by 15? If you do a slash, before you know it, this is that. It's gone from 11 fifteenths to 11,115. Because that's what happens. I know I've been teaching kids for decades now, and that's what happens. So if it's numbers, I want flat fraction bars. You can do the slash if it's units. All right, now converting between units. I'm going to teach you the chemistry way to do it because I'm a chemistry teacher. And I call them the railroad tracks, and it's converting units. So they said, so I'm going to show you how to change 4 hours into seconds. I want to know how many seconds, that doesn't say C, it says seconds. How many seconds are in 4 hours? So first you start with what you're given, you're known, and it was 4 hours. Then you draw these railroad tracks, and you put the unit of what you know on the bottom, because we want to get rid of it and cross it out. Then you put its equivalent in the numerator, and the with the numbers that go with them. 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. The reason why this works mathematically is 60 minutes and 1 hour are the same thing. Anything divided by itself is one, and if you multiply it by one, you don't change its value, just its units. If that didn't make sense, don't worry about it. All right, so now our hours cancel out because I have one in the numerator and one in the denominator, and now I have minutes. But that isn't what it asked for. It asked for seconds. So I put minutes in the denominator because I want them to cancel out. I write seconds on top, and I write the relationship. There's 60 seconds in 1 minute. Minutes cancel out. You don't cancel out the numbers, just the units. Any number on top gets multiplied. Any number on bottom gets divided. But if either one is one, you can skip it. So this is 4 times 60 times 60. And that would tell us, we could put it in our calculator, it would tell us how many seconds are in 4 hours. So I'll do it. I didn't realize I hadn't done it. I'll do it real quick. So 4 times 60 times 60 is 14,400. So we'll say equals 14. And my unit is seconds. Okay, so there's the answer. All right, so here's one out of the book. And I set these up different than the book, and students always understand my way better, so make sure you understand it. It says we have 500, I think it's a plane or something, going 540 miles per hour, and we want to know how many miles it's going per minute. So anything on in the numerator goes on top, per hour, hour goes on bottom, and the number that goes with that hour, because it doesn't have one, is one. It goes 540 miles in 1 hour. If there's no number, it's an understood one. Okay, so I put mile, what I'm trying to get rid of is hours, and hours is on the bottom, so I write it on top. And then what I'm trying to change it to is minutes, so I write it on bottom. Hours cancel out. Any number on top you multiply, any number on bottom you divide, but you get to skip the ones. So it's 540 divided by 60 is 9 miles per minute. Do you see how miles and minute were left? Miles in the numerator, minute in the denominator. Here's another one. We've got a robot that goes 1 inch in 3 seconds, and we want to know how many inches it goes. No. How many feet it goes. In right, inch feet, how many feet it goes per minute. So we start with what we know, 1 inch in 3 seconds. Then we want to change inches to feet, so I write inch on the denominator, those cancel out, and the relationship between feet and inches is, this was from Rebecca, stop kaput, 12 inches in a foot. There you go. There's your rhyme for that one. So stop kaput, 12 inches in a foot. Inches work out. Now, so I got feet, but now I need these seconds converted to minutes. I'll need seconds in the numerator, so those can work out, and there's 60 seconds in 1 minute. One times 60 is 60, divided by 3 times 12, you end up with 20. 20 feet in 1 minute. And then it says, well, if it's 4 minutes, how far is it going to go? So my rate, my conversion factor, is it goes 20 inches in 1 minute. I guess that was inches. I think I changed it. Look at the problem in the book and you can see what it was. But you kind of get the idea. I changed it to feet. Feet per minute. I'll have to look at that, but you look at it too in the book. But as long as you kind of get the idea, we're good. So we have 4 minutes. We want minutes to cancel out. And 1 minute equals 20 inches. I guess that goes back to our original thing or something. And then we want to change that to feet. And the relationship between feet and inches is stop kaput, 12 inches in a foot. Inches mark out. And we end up that it is 6.66 on the calculator. Do math enter, and you get 20/3. And in algebra 1, that's the answer we would do. But in pre-algebra, they still like mixed numbers, and it's 6 2/3 feet. Look at the problem in the book. I might have switched up what they were asking or something, but that's basically the idea. And you just kind of have to a little bit understand this at this point. We will get much better at this in Algebra 1 and once you hit chemistry. So this is just an introduction. Don't worry about it too much if it seems a little confusing. If you just get the basic idea that about conversion factors, then you've got enough from this, all right? Math is great. See you next time.